Hello and welcome back. Of course, here again we're going to continue from where I stopped from. I've already created this table in the three previous video tutorials. Please, if you don't begin with us, go and watch those video tutorials while creating this HTML table. So we're going to resume from where we stopped from exactly. So today we're going to look at the call span and the row span. For example, I want to put here my total. I want to put here my total, and I want the one row to begin from here up to here, and then the total should be displayed here. To do that, it means that I'll need another row here at the end of this table. So I'll write again TR and press the tab key, and I'll have two things. One is the table, the table data, maybe you can use table data or what, table head. Since it's solid, or want to be bolded, I use table head, table H. Okay, so if it is just mere data, you can use just table data TD. So I'll put here my word total, and the end I'll put again TH, then I'll put what? TH, and then I'll put here my total. Maybe let's say, how much can this be? I will not calculate, maybe say 540, like that. Okay, so let us run the program and see. not running, but save and execute. Say open browser. You can see the output, that is the table. But I want this table to come here. I mean, I want this 540 to come here as the total, and then this total should be having a free space from here up to here. Okay, that's the problem. So I want this total to span this 1, 2, 3, 4 to span 4 columns, and then this should be in the last one here, should be next to it. So to do that, we just come here to the total. You see, it is the total that want to push this one here. To do that, we just come here to the total attribute in the first attribute, I mean the first word, in the first tag, and put the word the call span. Okay, then you put the number of columns that you want this total tag to span, maybe 3. Okay, maybe 3. So it means that it's going to span 1, 2, 3 tags, I mean columns, you can see. So you need to add one more for it to make 4. Okay, so when you put here 4, you'll see the word total is spanning the whole of this space, and this one is next to it. So that's what we call call span. So row span is also the same, but for it we just put it in the table row, and you span the row spans that you want one row to span. For example, I want this heading row to be spanning two tags or two spaces. So to do that, I'll come in this heading row and write the what? Row span is equal to maybe 2. So if I come and refresh, and you can see it is now spanning 2 rows, exactly like what I said. So that's it about row span and the table span. So I hope you've got the concept. In fact, you put it here. I hope you've got the concept of row span. Is this word correct? No. Of row span and call span. If you got it, then that's it. If you don't get, then please put your problem in the comment section, and I'm ready to respond to it. Let's meet in the next video tutorial, where we're going to look at another element of HTML. I hope you'll not miss. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you for watching.